Fox News Update, I'm Trace Gallagher. On Facebook Watch, a bombshell third accusation against Judge Brett Kavanaugh just a day before the Supreme Court nominee and his first accuser are set to testify before the Senate Judiciary Committee. The woman says Kavanaugh was present when she was gang raped at a house party 3 decades ago. In a sworn statement, Julie Swetnick claims that she became aware of efforts by Kavanaugh and others to spike the punch at parties she went to with drugs and grain alcohol so girls could lose their inhibitions and their ability to say no. Her lawyer, Michael Avenatti, released Swetnick's written statement on his Twitter account. Kavanaugh denies it. He released a statement which reads, "This is ridiculous and from the Twilight Zone. I don't know who this is. And this never happened." His first accuser, Christine Blasey Ford, says Kavanaugh sexually assaulted her when they were both in high school. The Supreme Court nominee denies that as well. Top Democrats on the Senate Judiciary Committee trying to delay Kavanaugh's confirmation. They sent a letter to President Trump asking him to withdraw Kavanaugh's nomination or open an FBI investigation into the claims. Committee Chairman, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley of Iowa, says his lawyers are talking to the third accuser. Our chief congressional correspondent, Mike Emanuel, is live for us on Capitol Hill with more. And Mike, Ford apparently submitted some paperwork documents before tomorrow's hearing.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Trace. They sent in a handwritten note from her in her actual handwriting where you can see crossouts and everything and also results of a polygraph test. On the handwritten note, it is her account of what she says happened to her 36 years ago. She says she went to a party in the Washington, D.C. area. She went to use the restroom, was shoved then into a bedroom, and she says Brett Kavanaugh climbed on top of her. His friend Mark Judge was also in the room. I should note that Kavanaugh and Mark Judge have both said it didn't happen. Now to the results of the polygraph test. The conclusion is, quote, "It is the professional opinion of this examiner that Blasey's responses to the above relevant questions are not indicative of deception." So that sets the stage for tomorrow's hearing here on Capitol Hill and provides some more background information for lawmakers going into that hearing. Trace.
And Mike, now we have this kind of third bombshell accusation. What do we know about this third accuser?
Well, Julie Swetnick is her name. She's represented by Michael Avenatti, who used to be Stormy Daniels' attorney. More on that in a moment. But Swetnick says in the early 1980s, she went to parties in the Washington, D.C. area. They were given alcohol and drugs. She claims she was gang raped. She does not accuse Kavanaugh of rape. And I should note that Kavanaugh says this is all from the Twilight Zone. He doesn't know who she is. But bottom line, she says that she was at parties where boys gang raped girls. President Trump fired back at the attorney on Twitter saying, quote, "Avenatti is a third-rate lawyer who is good at making false accusations like he did on me and like he is now doing on Judge Brett Kavanaugh. He is just looking for attention and doesn't want people to look at his past record and relationships. A total lowlife." I should note that some lawmakers here on Capitol Hill are very suspicious of this coming up at the last minute before tomorrow's hearing and ahead of a committee vote expected on Friday, Trace.
And sounds like, Mike, tomorrow's hearing is still on schedule. What are we hearing from senators on both sides?
No question about it. I should note Michael Avenatti is still Stormy Daniels' attorney. That is my bad. But here on Capitol Hill, emotions are running really high. Take a listen to New York Democrat Senator Kirsten Gillibrand.
"We're not actually seeking to convict him or put him in jail. We are seeking the truth. We are seeking facts. We are seeking just what happened."
And also this afternoon, a Republican on the Judiciary Committee talked about how nasty things have gotten.
"Some of the public comments about both of these witnesses have been vile. Not unrelated to these comments, each of these witnesses have reportedly been subject to death threats. And for that, we should be ashamed. The toxic political culture that we have created has infected everything."
Thursday morning, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. Eastern, Christine Blasey Ford goes first, and then Judge Kavanaugh has an opportunity to respond. Trace.
Our chief congressional correspondent, Mike Emanuel, live for us on Capitol Hill. Mike, thank you. Check out Fox News for more on today's biggest stories on cable, satellite, radio, and right here on Facebook Watch, live or on demand. I'm Trace Gallagher.